I'm Cody Smith, Technical Support Manager for Cloyes Gear and Products. And in this video, we'll be covering timing system replacement in GM Gen 3 and Gen 4 small block V8 engines, commonly referred to as the LS series engines. This includes 4.8, 5.3, 5.7, 6.0, 6.2, and 7.0 engine displacements. Cloyes offers a full line of stock replacement components and kits for the Gen 3 and Gen 4 engines. In addition, we offer a full high-performance product line with adjustable machine billet sprockets and hand-matched performance racing timing drive sets. Here's a look at the timing components we'll be installing in this video. Kit number 94205SA contains the camshaft sprocket, crankshaft sprocket, chain, and tensioner required for our 2007 5.3 liter engine. Note that the camshaft sprocket we're installing has a single center bolt hole and four raised cam sensor lugs. Three bolt attachment pattern sprockets were also used that may have either a single lug or four sensor lugs. These features must match the original cam sprocket for both the sprocket to install and provide the correct cam sensor trigger. If you are working on a Gen 4 application, you may find a variable valve timing camshaft phaser, or also referred to as a camshaft position actuator, instead of a one-piece sprocket. The phaser is held in place by a special valving bolt that must be replaced upon removal. Also, be aware that not all engines use a tensioner. Some use a solid guide, and others have no guide or tensioner at all. Please refer to the Cloyes Buyer's Guide for correct kit and individual component compatibility. Timing system replacement can be done with the engine in the vehicle, but it will be necessary to pull the oil pan to service the timing components. The oil pump is driven off the crank nose, and the oil pan must be removed to access and remove the oil pump pickup tube. With that said, let's start by removing the water pump, the oil pan, the harmonic balancer, the front timing cover, then the oil pump pickup tube, and the oil pump. Now with the pump out of the way, rotate the engine to align the timing marks in the center. The cam sprocket mark at the 6 o'clock position and the crank sprocket mark at the 12 o'clock position. You can then remove the cam sprocket bolt or bolts and remove the cam sprocket and chain. Next, remove the tensioner or guide if equipped. Then remove the crankshaft sprocket using an appropriate tool. We used a generic 3-jaw puller. Because of the interference fit, installation of the new crankshaft sprocket will also require a special tool. We managed to make our own using the old crankshaft sprocket, a washer, and the old balancer bolt. Make sure the crankshaft key is aligned to the sprocket's key slot, then press the new sprocket into place until it's fully seated against the crankshaft front face. Do not use a hammer to install the sprocket. Check your timing mark and ensure it's still at the 12 o'clock position. You can now install the tensioner or guide assembly if required. Torque the tensioner or guide bolts to 18 foot-pounds. Next, install the chain and camshaft sprocket, ensuring the sprocket is aligned properly with the camshaft dowel. Timing marks once again must be aligned in the middle for proper timing. For now, hand tighten the attachment bolt or bolts. Check for timing mark alignment and pull the tensioner activation pin if it applies. You are now ready to torque the cam sprocket bolt or bolts. For single bolt applications, torque to 55 foot-pounds, then an additional 50 degrees. For three bolt applications, torque the bolts to 26 foot-pounds, or on VVT equipped engines, torque the valve bolt to 48 foot-pounds, then an additional 90 degrees. This completes the timing system installation. Reinstall the oil pump, torquing the bolts to 18 foot-pounds, followed by the oil pump inlet tube. Torque the bolt to 106 inch-pounds and the nuts to 18 foot-pounds. Special precautions must be taken during oil pan and timing cover installation. Neither has any dowels to ensure proper alignment with the engine. Start with the oil pan. Apply two small beads of silicone at the rear cover gasket joints of the pan, then install the gasket. Now install the oil pan and loosely install the bolts so the pan is in place but can still be adjusted for proper alignment. Ensure the back of the pan is flush with the bell housing plane of the engine or is fully mated with the transmission mounting surface. For in-vehicle repairs, accomplish this by tightening the bell housing bolts first. Torque the 8mm bolts to 18 foot-pounds and the 6mm bolts to 106 inch-pounds. Now with the pan properly installed, we can install the timing cover. Start by applying a small bead of silicone at the two front cover joints of the oil pan. Note that GM recommends using a special tool to properly position the cover in relation to the crankshaft nose. Improper cover positioning will cause premature wear to the front seal. You're now ready to reinstall a harmonic balancer, water pump, and accessory drives. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, please contact our tech line, and please subscribe to our channel.